Hi guys, thank you for watching, and in this video we are gonna cover the polygon. So poly means many and gons mean angle, so this means a shape which have many angles. So let's go into the Solidworks and let's see how it works. So the first thing first, we are gonna go and we are gonna select our first fundamental plane, and then we are ready into the tab menus, and into the ribbon section you can see there is an option under the slots that is called polygon. So as soon as I'm gonna go into the polygons, the first thing is, do I want to use this polygon for the construction? If you want to use it for the construction, then you can just mark this. Otherwise, the most important parameter is how many shapes, how many angles do you want for the polygon. So it can be 5, it can be 6, or it can be 3. So if I'm going to select the 3, then it's going to be a triangle. Suppose I want to select it like this, 3. And then there are two more options. I'm just gonna draw my first triangle here by using the polygon tool. So the first thing is inscribe circle. So do you want this inscribe circle? It means circle is gonna be inside of the triangle. And if you want to have a circumscribed circle, then circle is gonna be outside of the triangle. And there is another option, like you can control the sides, you can control the circle and whatever. Still, you have a lot of flexibility. If you want to change the size, what you can do is you can just change the diameter of the circle. It's 120, let's move it to the 100. So what you can do is you can change the diameter of the circle, or another thing is I can just double click it, I can move this value anywhere. Or the another thing is, if you don't need it, what you can do is you can just select this and then you can hit delete key on your keyboard. Let's go, I'm gonna select this dimension and then I'm gonna click the delete. Or there is another thing, if you want to control the sides or lengths, what you can do is you can just change the length of the triangle or any side. Suppose I want to say it 50, so it's gonna be moved to 50. So in this way I can control the dimensions as well. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you would find a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email, which is given into the description of this video. Thank you. So let's go into the polygon again and let's draw some other polygons as well. So this time I'm going to go with the 7 sides, and then I want to go with the inscribed circles. Okay, I'm fine with it. So first you need to choose the center point, and then you can just rotate around that center point, and in this way you are going to have a polygon of 7 angles. And this is inscribed circle, so that's why a circle is inside. So there is one more option, you can go into the lines, you can draw a center line from this point till this point if you want to have this point into the center. So in this way you can control this. And then what I'm gonna do is I just want to make this line as a vertical line. So in this way I'm gonna control the shape of my polygon, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. Okay, so this is my 7 angle shape of my polygon. So one more thing, as you can see there is a lot of relations between the sides. So if you are gonna delete this relation, and then you have a lot of flexibility. I'm gonna delete this relation, and now you have a lot of flexibility. You can just change the shape, you can move it as you want. So I'm gonna go back, I don't want to delete it, and so I have this my whole 7 angle polygon. So what I want to do is, if I want to modify my polygon for the some angle or from some of my design, so what I can do is, the first thing is, like I would say, like no need to delete these sides. So what you can do is, if you don't want to use any of these two sides, so first what you can do is you can just select this, select that, and then you can just move these two sides into the construction geometry. So look at that, we have the whole polygon and these two sides are construction. So next thing what I can do is, if I want to modify, I can just make a couple of lines here just to modify my design, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. So if you want to have your design, or if you want to modify your design, so in this way what you can do is you can just modify your design. Let's extrude them. So look at that, in this way by using polygon, what you can do is you can just modify your polygons. So this was all about the polygons. You can have as many sides as you want, and you have a lot of control to change the sizes, to change the shapes and everything. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.